Following distribution gives the state-wise teacher-student ratio in higher secondary schools of India. Find the mode and the median of this data, interpret the two measures. Okay. So what the data says that in individual, which state which has different states are given, and the data about the number of teachers in a particular school or number of teachers for related to a particular number of students is given, that is the ratio. Okay, for example, if the ratio is 5:1, so 5:1 represents that if for every five students I have one teacher. Okay, this is like a ratio. Basically this ratio is calculated to know how much teachers are working in this field of education in particular state, in which state. Okay, so it gives the state wise teacher student ratio and you can see the number of students per teacher. Okay, number of students per teacher, and the second column is number of states. So what the data is, number of students per teacher represents that for individually one teacher, for one teacher how many students are going to be in its in teachers span, us teacher ke under mein kitne students aate hain, that is basically the number of students per teacher. So the data is given as number of students per teacher. What is this? For example, in your class there are 60 students or 50 students and one class teacher. So I will say that number of students per teacher in your class is 60. So it means if there is only one class teacher, one teacher who is going to teach 60 students. So in this manner the data is given as, first you can see it is 15 to 20. So what does this 15 to 20 represents? It represents that number of students related to one teacher or number of students under one teacher is 15 to 20, and here you can see number of states / union territory. This is given. Okay, number of states / union territory, and this is 3. So what does this data represent? That there are 3 states or union territories where for every one teacher, for every individual teacher, there are 15 to 20 students. There are group of 15 to 20 students. Okay, so the second data is 20 to 25, third is 25 to 30, then 30 to 35, then 35 to 40, 40 to 45, then 45 to 50, and 50 to 55. Okay, and the frequency is given as 3, then 8, then 9, then 10, then 3, then 0 0, and then 2. So what you can see, this data gives the number of students per teacher, that is number of students under one teacher. So there are 3 states or union territories where individual teacher, okay, under individual teacher, under single teacher, there are 15 to 20 students, and there are 2 states which has 50 to 55 students under one teacher. So what you can conclude, you can conclude that in these 2 states or union territories there are less number of teachers, okay, or maybe there are more number of students. So you can see, because there are only there are few teachers, there are less teachers, so that's why each teacher controls 50 to 55 students. It's a huge strength. And similarly in these 3 states I can see one teacher controls only 15 to 20 students. So maybe I can say that these 3 states are more literate states or more developed states, and these 2 states are some kind of backward states. Okay, this is like an interpretation we can draw from this data. Okay, so our task is to calculate the mean and the mode. So how to calculate the mean? For calculating the mean I will calculate class marks. And how to calculate class marks? It is 15 plus 20 by 2, that is 35 by 2, so it is 17.5. Then similarly, second is 20 plus 25 by 2, it is 45 by 2, that is 22.5. Then this will be 27.5, then this will be 32.5, then 37.5, okay. This is this and this one will be 42.5 and this one will be 47.5 and this one will be 52.5. So this is the class marks. Then we will take any of these value as the mean. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again we have 8 observations. So let us take this 32.5 as the mean or assumed mean. So A will be equals to, where I can write it here. A is equals to 32.5, and if I have the class marks, I can calculate the deviation DI as XI minus A. So how will you calculate the deviation? Just subtract the two values. Just subtract the two values. The 17.5 minus 32.5. Here you will get 22.5 minus 32.5. And here 27.5 minus 32.5 and so on, okay. So this comes out to be minus 15, then minus 5, then minus this will be minus 10, this will be minus 5 and then 0, then 5, 10, in this way. Now after that we will calculate frequency into deviation, Fi into Di. So how will you calculate Fi into Di? This is Fi, 3 into this value you will get Fi, then 8 into this value you will get another Fi Di. So similarly you can calculate all these values, okay, and finally you can calculate summation Fi Di. So in this way you can calculate the summation Fi Di, and we will simply apply the formula for mean, that is equals to A plus summation Fi Di upon summation Fi, and in this way you can get the mean value, and I have the mean value already calculated. The mean value is 29.22 is the mean value. Now to calculate the mode, we will find the modal class. The class with maximum frequency is this one. So for this 10, it will correspond to this class 32, 35. This is the modal class. So modal class is 32, 35. Now we will apply the formula for mode. Mode is equals to L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2 times F1 minus F0 minus F2, okay, into H. So what is L? Lower limit of this modal class is 30, then frequency of this modal class, frequency is 10, then frequency of preceding class, it is 9, and frequency of succeeding class, it is 3, and the class width is 35 minus 30, that is 5. So this is the class width. So you can calculate the mode by substituting these values, and finally the mode will come out to be, the mode value will come out to be 30.6. Okay, so we have mode as 30.6 and we have mean as 29.22. So what does this mean? It means the maximum states or maximum teachers have 30 students under their control, okay. So number of students per teacher is maximum is 30, okay. So what does this mean? I have total states, I have, let us say, 28 states or 32 states or 30 states. For these 30 states, if I check the number of students per teacher, I will find that maximum states has 30 students per teacher, okay. So I can interpret it, I can write it as it represent maximum states, or it represents 30.6 represents the number of students, maximum it represent maximum states where number of students, let me write it again, what does this represent? It represent that maximum states have 30.6 students per teacher. Okay, it represents that maximum states, ज्यादातर states पे 30.6 students है per teacher. हमें यहां पर दिखता है कि 15 to 20 students per teacher तीन states में है. Okay? Then 20 to 25 students per teacher 8 states में है. 8 states ऐसे हैं जहां पर हर teacher पे कितने students हैं? 20 to 25. तो हमने इसका mode निकाला. Mode means maximum states जो इस list में added हैं, उनमें कितने students per teacher हैं? 30.6 students per teacher. And what does this represent? Excuse me. What does this represent? It represents the average number of student. Okay, this is the average student that per teacher has in all the states. Okay, if we combine all the states, this is combined for all the states and this is for individual states. So in this way we can solve question number 13. Okay, please note this, then we will continue. Okay, let's now solve 14th question. It says the given distribution shows the number of runs scored by some top batsmen of the world in one day international cricket matches. So run scored and number of batsmen is given. Find the mode of this data. It means we need to determine what is the score that maximum batsman has made. Okay, we need to determine the number of scored number of runs scored by maximum batsman. Okay, so let's calculate this. Question number 14, the data is given as runs scored and number of batsmen. So runs scored and number of batsmen 3000 to 4000, it is 4. So what does this mean? Iska kya matlab hua? There are 4 batsmen in the world which scored runs between 3000 to 4000. Matlab world ke aise 4 hi batsmen aise available hain jinhone 3000 se 4000 ke beech mein run score kiye hain. Okay? Then next is 4000 to 5000, it is 18. Then 5000 to 6000, it is 9. Matlab aise 9 batsmen world mein hain jinhone 5000 se 6000 ki range mein runs banaye hain. Then 6000 to 7000, okay, this is 7. Then 7000 to 8000 and 8000 to 9000. Then 9000 to 10,000 and then 10,000 to 11,000. Okay? And this is 6, then 3, then 1 and 1. So we have this number of batsmen and the runs scored by these batsmen. Now our task is to calculate the runs scored by maximum number of batsmen. That is the mode of this data. So we know the formula for mode is L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2 times F1 minus F0 minus F2 times H. For that we need to calculate the modal class. You can see the maximum frequency, the maximum number of batsmen scored runs between 4000 and 5000. So this is the 18, which is the maximum frequency, and it corresponds to this particular class. So I will say the modal class is ₹4000 to ₹5000. This is the modal class. So in the modal class I have lower limit as 4000. The frequency of modal class is 18. F0, that is the frequency of preceding class, is 4, and F2 frequency of succeeding class is 9, and H as 5000 minus 4000, that is 1000, the class width. So what you need to do, just substitute these values in the formula and you will get the final answer as mod of this given data will be 4608.695. So this is the mod, this is the runs scored by maximum number of batsmen. So what does this represent? It represents runs scored by maximum batsman. Okay, सबसे ज्यादा batsman ने, okay, जितने भी batsman को हमने देखा, सबसे ज्यादा batsman ने क्या करा, सबसे ज्यादा batsman ने 4608.695 runs बनाए हैं. This is the mode of this data. मतलब जितने भी बैट्समैन को आप एनालाइज करेंगे, मैक्सिमम ऑफ दोज बैट्समैन सिक्योर्ड 4608 runs. ओके, एंड देन दिस इज द 14th वन. देन द 15th वन, इट सेज अ स्टूडेंट नोटेड द नंबर ऑफ कार्स पासिंग थ्रू अ स्पॉट ऑन अ रोड फॉर 100 पीरियड्स ईच ऑफ 3 मिनट्स एंड समराइज्ड इट इन द टेबल गिवन बिलो. Find the mode of this data. So what it means to say, in a period of 3 minutes, okay, means he calculated, what he did is he spotted 100 cars, okay, in a period of 3 minutes, in 100 periods, okay. So 3 minutes period means, for let us say he started at 12, so from 12 to 12:03 it will be one period. Then 12:03 to 12:06 it will be second period. Then 12:06 to 12:09 it will be third period. So in this way he made 100 periods and each of minutes 3, and he spotted the number of cars passing in these individual periods. So the data is given as number of cars and the frequency. So number of cars is 0 to 10 and the frequency is 7. Now what does this mean? It means that there are 7 periods. There are 7 periods in those 100 periods. There are 7 periods in which the number of cars passing from a particular spot are 0 to 10. Let us say 12 to 12:03 is one period. So 12 to 12:03 it will be one period, and let us say the number of cars passing in that one period is 0 to 10. In similar manner I have 6 more periods. It means 7 bar aise periods aaye, 7 bar aise time ke durations aaye jahan par us particular period mein, us particular duration mein, us particular spot pe se 0 se 10 ke beech mein, okay, cars pass ho rahi thi. Then the data second is 10 to 20, 10 to 20 is 14. It means aise 14 periods dekhe gaye, aise 14 time slots dekhe gaye, jisme jo cars pass ho rahi hai, they are between 10 to 20. Okay, and then third one, it is 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70 and 70 to 80. These are some periods. This is 14, then 13, then 12, then 20, then 11, then 15, and then 8. So what does this represent? 7 slots ऐसे हैं जहां पर number of cars pass हो रही थी वो 0 to 10 के बीच में थी, और 8 slot पूरे दिन में 8 intervals ऐसे थे जहां पर जो cars pass हो रही थी they were between 70 to 80. So what I can infer, मैं कह सकता हूं कि ये जो slots हैं, ये 8 slots कौन से हैं? Maybe they are the morning slots, okay, or the evening slots, जब office का timings होता है, office timings वाले slot, for example, दिन के 11 बजे, 11:30 बजे, 12 बजे, तब क्या होता है? Traffic was maximum. तो traffic सबसे ज़्यादा होता है, in that way, I can say कि ऐसे ये जो 8 periods हैं, क्योंकि number of cars कितनी pass हो रही है? 70 to 80. So 70 to 80 cars एक particular spot से pass हो रही हैं. ऐसा कब होगा? Generally office hours में होगा. Office hours means 10 to 12. 10 to 12 के बीच में जो time है. और evening में some let us say 6 to 8. So ये office hours होते हैं. तो हम कह सकते हैं कि ये जो slots देखे गए, ये 8 slots generally इसी time period के बीच में होंगे. और इन 7 slots में जहाँ पर 0 to 10 के बीच में रही cars, तो मे बी ये स्लॉट्स कब हो सकते हैं? या तो अर्ली मॉर्निंग के या फिर लेट नाइट के. लेट अस से अर्ली मॉर्निंग मींस 6 टू 8, सुबह के 6 बजे से सुबह के 8 बजे तक. इन दैट पीरियड ट्रैफिक कम होता है, इसीलिए हम कहेंगे कि नंबर ऑफ कार जो पास हो रही थी वो कम थी. ओके okay? और आई कैन से इन द लेट नाइट, लेट अस से 10 टू 12, रात के 10 बजे से रात के 12 बजे के बीच में, इन दैट वे आई कैन से दीज स्लॉट्स आर फ्रॉम आइदर अर्ली मॉर्निंग और लेट नाइट. And there are some middle slots in noon, afternoon or evening. Okay, so this is what we can infer from this given data. Now my task is to calculate the mode of this data. Mode ka means I want to calculate that what is the maximum number of slots that have a particular number of cars passing. Okay, I want to calculate what is the number of cars passing from maximum number of slots, or number of cars observed in maximum number of slots. This is what the mode will represent. So in this case, mode will represent maximum. The mode will represent the number of cars passing, or number of cars observed in maximum periods. Maximum periods, number of cars observed means मुझे एक ऐसा value calculate करना है, मुझे number of cars calculate करनी है that were observed in maximum number of slots. ज़्यादातर slots में कितनी number of cars देखी गई, कितनी number of cars observe की गई, that is what my task is to calculate. So for that I can see this is the maximum frequency and this corresponds to this class. So this is the model class. So my model class is 40 to 50. So in this particular class I can see the L, that is the lower limit, is 40, then F1 is frequency of this class is 20, then F0 is frequency of previous class is 12, then frequency of succeeding class is 11, and class width is 50 minus 40, that is 10. So you can calculate the mode of this data, and mode will come out to be, the mode after calculation will be 44.7. So ye 44.7 kya represent karta hai? It represents the number of cars observed in maximum slots or maximum time periods. जो भी 100 टाइम पीरियड्स हमने एनालाइज करे, उनमें से मैक्सिमम टाइम पीरियड्स में हमने देखा कि 44.7 कार्स पास होनी चाहिए. ओके, दिस इज व्हाट द मोड रिप्रेजेंट. सो इन दिस वे यू कैन सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 15. सो दिस कंप्लीट्स अवर टॉपिक ऑफ मोड, एंड नाउ वी विल स्टडी द मीडियन. ओके, प्लीज नोट दिस.